I've turned into a basic bitch. We think I've got undiagnosed ADHD, which I actually would not be surprised about. Tiny house, tiny mind, that's the vibe I'm going for.
Stop imagining, guy right here, baby.
We've reached chaos level in the flat again, and I think it's from being busy. Like, if I'm getting a lot of work stuff done, my house falls into disarray. There is just stuff absolutely everywhere. But when I'm not super busy with work stuff, my house seems to be really clean and tidy. But I'm also still decluttering and stuff. So there's a video that went up on Thursday, which you may have seen, and I started decluttering my house, and I'm not gonna do it all in one big block. I'm basically finding little time chunks here and there, and I'm just clearing out whatever I can clear out in that time that makes our flat feel nicer and more homely and more cozy. So the first stage was the wardrobe, and stuff is going on Vinted across this weekend, so some of it will already be up. I'll leave a link if you wanna check out my Vinted. And I need to do on Friday a couple more bits actually. I'm gonna do my shoes, my coats, my bags, like all the other parts of the wardrobe basically. So there should be quite a lot going on Vinted actually, because I've been like piling stuff up. You know when you, like, I open my wardrobe sometimes and I look at a top and I'm like, I just don't wear you. Like, why are you still in here? So I'll pull it out and then I just fold it up and put it in a little pile in the bedroom, just so that I know that when I do come to doing Vinted, it's kind of all ready to go. I did the same with some swimwear bits that need to go up, like just random bits and pieces that just need to go up. So that will be happening on Friday. Today I have a day of doing videos and stuff for YouTube. So I've got a couple of haul videos, ways to style videos, etc. that I need to get done. I'm meeting my friend Rhiannon for a coffee later, which is gonna be really nice. She's house sitting not too far from here. She's actually moving around here, which is so exciting. But she's house sitting not that far away. So we said we're gonna meet at a halfway point, which is Maidenhead. She's not actually that close. Maidenhead's still like quite far for me. Like not an hour far, but still pretty far. So we're gonna be meeting there, and then she's like, we're basically both, I'm coming this way, she's coming that way kind of thing. So yeah, we're gonna meet there, and I found a really cute place called the Boathouse at Boulder's Lock, I think it's called. We're gonna try and go there because it's on the water, and I thought that would be quite cute because it's not that cold. Like, it's autumnal, but it's not freezing. So I thought that would be quite cute to sit outside and just be all like snuggled up in jumpers and stuff and sipping on hot chocolates. But I actually started the camera because I wanted to tell you that I'm a matcha convert. I've turned into a basic bitch. I when we were in San Francisco, I had matcha nearly 24/7, and I was having it in the basic bitch way as well, with oat milk or almond milk and vanilla syrup. So I bought myself the Blank Street coffee matcha, like the Blank Street coffee shop. You've probably seen it all over TikTok. It's quite like infamous at the moment, but they use Perfect Ted matcha. So I got this on Amazon. I'll try and see if I can find a link, because I went into Planet Organic yesterday to buy this raw chocolate company, vegan hot chocolate, which is actually really good. So I bought that yesterday, and they had this matcha, and it was, I think, I want to say it was $12.99, but I can't remember how much it was on Amazon, and I went to check, and then it was sold out on the link that I bought it, but I'll see if I can find it again. But basically, I was told by the girls I was in San Francisco with that you should always get ceremonial grade. Apparently, it just means it tastes way nicer, and it's better for you, I think. I don't really know. They just told me to make sure it was ceremonial grade, which is like organic, 100% pure, which I think is part of it. I think it's like the purity of the matcha. I don't bloody know. This one says it's 100% pure. 100% pure matcha, ceremonial grade, organic, 68 milligrams of caffeine per one teaspoon. And it says on here to put one teaspoon of matcha with 60 mils of water, mix until frothy, and then top with your choice of milk. So I used one teaspoon yesterday. Like, I used probably about that. Is that a tea? Right, what do you consider as a teaspoon? Because I would say that is like half a teaspoon. But then, like, I count a teaspoon as like a heaped teaspoon. But then your teaspoon might be different. You know, the logic of teaspoons is just not an ideal measurement. But I'm going to go for one, because one yesterday tasted quite nice. And then I bought, I didn't realise it was this big, I'll be completely honest. I thought it was going to be like this size. But I bought a bulk zero calorie barista syrup, because we actually ran out of pre-workout, so I just got this one. The Naked Harvest ones I absolutely love, and I really did want to buy again. The only thing is, last time I bought it, I got it in the Black Friday sales, and I bought like four or five pre-workouts to justify the £17 postage because it comes from Australia. So I think when it gets to Black Friday again in a couple of weeks, I'll buy the Naked Harvest ones. But this one between us, I think there's like 30 servings in here or something. Yeah, 30 servings. So we don't have full servings, we have like half. So this will last me and James combined for a month if we worked out every single day. So it lasts us like pretty much till the Black Friday sales. But this is really yummy. It's the bulk Millions ones. So they've done like refreshers and like dip dads and stuff. But it's blackcurrant Millions and it tastes really good. We got that and then I just thought I'd chuck this into the basket as well. So I just kind of eyeball that, to be honest. But let me just, I'm trying to do this for TikTok at the same time. If you don't follow me on TikTok, by the way, I am very active on TikTok. I absolutely love it. So I've been doing a lot more bits and pieces over there if you want to check that out. But yeah, I'm going to quickly wipe my camera for one because it's filthy. I'm just going to film the matcha. Give it a good frothy froth. Let me aim the camera down actually and you can see what I'm doing. It's so good. I do think if you are someone who finds matcha a bit grassy, then definitely try putting some syrup in. So this is just the vanilla one, like I said, or just try putting a little bit less matcha. I did a teaspoon and this is a little bit grassy, but I find that if you do what they say and put a tiny bit of water and then really froth it up and then you add a bit more water and then milk, it's not as like gritty either, which is really nice. But I love it. And apparently matcha is better for caffeine as well because it's more of a slow release. So you get the same amount of caffeine as you would from a coffee. But I don't know if this is like gospel, but apparently it's more like slow releasing. So where coffee gives you like the instant hit, matcha is more of like a slow buzz. I'm spending the day filming some bits and honestly having the time of my life. Some days I really love filming videos and I get into it really easily, and some days I love filming, I always love filming them, but some days I find it considerably harder to get into filming because I, as my therapist has said and multiple other people around me, we think I've got undiagnosed ADHD, which I actually would not be surprised about because there's so, like, I've never seen a video about ADHD and it's not relevant to my life. Like, me and James send them to each other all the time because we find it so funny. But I find it really hard to focus on a task, especially when I'm at home and I've got everything around me and I'm trying to prep myself to do something, because like my brain's like running all over the show. Like, I was mid filming and then I walked towards the kitchen and I tripped over the Hoover and then I just started hoovering and then I stopped hoovering and then I made myself a coffee. And then, you know, when you're just like, what is wrong with my brain? Like, why can I not function? So what I've done is taken some of my tablets that I usually take, I'll show you them in a second, popped on Vanderpump Rules. I finally got to season 9. I already know the spoilers, so don't worry about if you like let a spoiler slip, but I am just at the point of Palm Springs where someone proposes to someone. So, really loving that, and it's quite a good like background thing because I not always when I'm working, like if I really need to concentrate and like write or something, then I won't watch TV, or like if I'm editing. But if I'm just running around filming videos, I don't really mind. I just sit and watch TV because it's like when I'm not, like if I'm doing cutaways or something when I don't need to be talking, it's quite nice. But let me show you the pills I've been taking because they're really, really good and they're completely natural. Hang on. Ignore the fact the packet's empty. I've popped them in a little jar because I, like, we have spare jars in the cupboard and me and James were like, why are we not just using them for things that we've got? And then it makes sense. So I popped them in a jar, but I kept the packet just because I wanted to make sure that I remembered the name. So these are from a brand called Cognitively and they are focus tablets for brain wellness. And they have a couple of other, I think there's like maybe one other different product or two other different products. But I saw this as a TikTok ad that had come up, like a sponsored TikTok, and it was basically this woman whose daughter has ADHD. She used to be on medication. The medication made her feel really bad, it affected her mental health, etc. So this woman who is like a natural, so like she deals with like more natural, I can't remember the name of it, but one of my friends in Australia, Adrian, he actually does a pretty similar job. But it's basically like natural pharmaceuticals, I guess you could say. So I've researched this heavily. I've had other people in my life who have also looked into it, and it's basically free from dairy, gluten, yeast, free from preservatives, suitable for vegans, and you take 3 to 6 capsules daily with food or as directed by a healthcare professional. So what I typically do is if I have had breakfast and I really, really need to focus, I'll take like 4 straight away first thing in the morning, or I'll take 2 with breakfast, 2 with lunch, and then 2 with dinner, or like 3 and 3, because I don't feel like I really need them overnight. I feel like I need them more bursting throughout the day. So that's what I do, but it's got like a big list of ingredients that's all things that you would need. I don't obviously know the full ins and outs of this, like I'm not a medical professional, so I would advise looking into it yourself, but I've been taking these for a month, maybe, whenever I've been at home and I've really needed to focus, and honestly, so game changing. This morning I was running around and I just did not want to film. I was getting so, like, I wanted to film, but I just couldn't make my brain stay focused, and as soon as I take them, I find that I don't feel any different, but I feel like all the flying thoughts in my brain, listen to my latest podcast and you'll know what I mean, but all the thoughts that are like flying around my brain just seem to go a bit quieter, so I can like focus on the thing that I really need to do and the thing that's important. So it really, really helps. So I've been taking those, and I would recommend going and getting advice from a doctor or a medical professional if you're going to start taking them, or maybe take like a really small dose or something. Like, obviously I am not a trained professional. I don't have a clue about pharmaceuticals and all that kind of stuff. I just know that they've worked for me, and I know that, like, from looking into it myself, my friend Georgia, who's looked into it, she does all nutrition and kind of stuff like that. James is really big on nutrition and stuff as well. He's looked into it. So I feel like a few people have vetted it, and I'm going to run it by my doctor as well, but it was literally created for people with ADHD who want a more natural thing. So I've been taking it, but I need to get out of this because I'm absolutely roasting and I really need to crack on, because I've got at least one more video to get filmed before I leave the house in 2 hours. I'm having one of those PMS-y days where I'm absolutely exhausted and no amount of caffeine is helping, and I just feel really like sluggish and weird and like not anxious, but you know, like angsty. So like, I'm not anxious, but I feel like I've got that like brewing of a feeling that could turn into anxiety if I let it, but it's like, it's kind of just sat there like brewing at the moment. So we're just leaving her sat there, and we're hoping that she goes away. This is probably not going to help. However, this will help my mood and it will help my energy levels at the moment. But I'm holding scissors because I was about to tell you I've got a parcel that just turned up, so I thought I'd open it on the vlog. But I realise it looks ridiculous that I'm just like talking about how I'm PMSing and feeling really grumpy and angsty while waving around scissors. Need to stop waving around scissors. But as I said, a giant box just turned up, so I thought I'd open it up and just see what's in here, and then we can have a little look together. I actually have no idea what this is. There's been a few bits at the moment that have just turned up and I'm like, oh, lovely. Ooh, it's a Vinted order. Oh my God. So I was on the hunt for a brown leather jacket. This is so heavy. And I found a guy on Vinted selling a brown leather jacket. It's men's 2XL, so I'm not entirely sure like what the fit of this is going to be like. And it's clearly like a biker jacket, but I just thought it might be quite cool. It smells like it needs a bit of a wash, you know, and it smells a bit like musty. But I just thought it might look quite... It's okay, no, it's way too big. I like the idea, but it is way too big. I don't know if I would be able to get the sleeves turned up, like get them taken up, but it's absolutely ginormous. But let me show you in the mirror because it's so nice. It cost me 30 quid and it's a brand. I can't remember what the brand name is because I've now put it on, whatever that says. But it's a brand that is like roughly about £200 brand new. And it's like a nice heavy leather jacket. But let me show you because I feel like it's just a little bit too oversized. Ignoring all of the crap behind me, this is what it looks like. What do we think? Do we think it looks too big? I feel like the body is fine. It's the sleeves, and I'm not a big fan of this like striped inside, but I do feel like the actual jacket fits okay. I'm just wondering if I would be able to get the sleeves taken up because obviously it is like real leather. I don't know. I might try and speak to a seamstress and just see if I can get it taken up, because if I got them taken up to like where the top of the stripe is, so like that bit, then I feel like it would look so nice. Or even if I just got it taken up to where it fits on my hand right now, it would be okay. But like, if I show you, hang on, this just looks ridiculous. Like the sleeves, like you can't even see my fingers, like I'm wiggling my fingers and you can't even see, like look, wiggling. So it's definitely way too big. The only time it looks fine is if I'm like this, but like actually day to day walking around, if I've got my arm down, I look ridiculous. So annoying, but it is a really, really lush jacket. I love it. It's just absolutely ginormous. Oh my God, I think I've temporarily resolved. I tucked the sleeves inwards instead of outwards, and it seems like they're holding quite well. So I think that might be like a temporary resolution to the situation, because that kind of worked. Kind of works. Yes, love this. Like I said, it only cost me about £30, so very chuffed.
Love.
Ree's vlog debut.
Hello.
Have you been in my vlog?
Hi.
Bali.
Yeah, I don't know about any other vlog.
This is Rhiannon. She's very cute. You should follow her on Instagram.
Be famous instead. I love you.
Guys, Tash and I have rented a little studio for the day and we've been shooting loads of like bits and pieces. I did try and give you some cutaways, but the camera has run out of battery. So, not battery, it's run out of memory, but I need everything on it. So we're gonna have some phone clips, but my phone is on like 5% and we've been cracking on for the last like 4 hours. So I just wanted to give you a quick overview because it's so cute in here. I absolutely love it. We've got quite a bit done, but we've got like 20 minutes left. So we're gonna quickly power through and try and get as much as we can done in 20 minutes and then time to head off for a festive afternoon tea, which is very exciting. It's not even November yet, but we're going full Christmas. Cute, they've got like all these really neutral bits. So nice. And then there's like cute little sofa, Tash's leftover Joe and the Juice. Tash. Just quite a few bits, it's quite nice. So we've been making the most of it and like using it in different spaces at the same time so that it's like good for both of us, but yeah. Got a slightly different angle going on because I've just done a bit of a declutter for my declutter organize series that started on Thursday. So I'm making it a bit different to ones that I've done before in that it's not going to be that I do a huge declutter all in 1 week. I'm kind of doing it sporadically. So every time I can spare a little bit of time in a week or a month, then I'm just allotting time to myself to clear out a certain area. So last time, I think it was about 2 or 3 weeks ago, and I did the wardrobes. So I cleared out anything that I didn't want anymore. I sorted out all of my summer stuff into some storage so that it's not taking up space in the wardrobe while I don't need it. And I basically just went through and like sorted out absolutely everything. So that one went up on Thursday if you want to check it out. I quite like it. It's a bit different to my like trying on everything I own kind of videos because it was more about like going through everything and just seeing what I have, seeing what I need, seeing what I don't need. I come from a family of extreme hoarders. Like, there's people in my family who hoard a lot. Like, they have a lot of stuff. So I have tendencies of doing the same thing, and I don't want to be like that anymore. I want to be more like my mum, who has, like, nothing. So I'm trying to really just minimise down what I have, what I use, and that's kind of what it is. And also, like, me and James have moved two properties into one, so there's a lot of stuff, and I just want to make sure that my side of things is as minimal and as, like, reduced down as possible, because for one, it gives us space, which I think is super important when you live somewhere. Like, you just tidy house, tidy mind. That's the vibe I'm going for. So we really wanted to minimize down so that we have space. I can never find anything because I just have so much stuff. I just like push things into cupboards. So it was for space, it was for like clean mind, clean everything, like clean life, etc. But also sometimes it's quite nice to just donate things or sell things to make some money or give things to friends. And anything that I'm selling, the money's basically going straight back into buying a house in the future. So I just really wanted to like purge, basically. I had this overwhelming feeling that I needed to just purge things. So that's what I'm doing. I've been watching lots of things about decluttering and organizing and minimizing and all those things. And I just, anything that doesn't serve a purpose in my life, sorry, I've got really itchy nose, I've got like a fiber. You know when you get like a scarf fiber or something, I think where I've been doing the cupboards. But yeah, anything that doesn't serve a purpose is leaving the building. And I'm very happy about it and I'm very glad about it. And James is a minimal person anyway, like he just doesn't really own much stuff. So it's kind of made me aware of how much I have, seeing like how much of mine is in this house and how much of his, because even in the wardrobes, there's a considerable difference. And I'm aware men just don't have as much stuff, but like it needs to be purged. So that's what we're doing. But I stopped for a bit of lunch before I take some vintage pictures. There is going to be vintage stuff going up this weekend. I'm not entirely sure what or how much because it depends what I get pictures of today, but I'm hoping that I can try and get at least like a good chunk of stuff up tomorrow. I'm thinking I might do it as more of like every few days I upload, but it's like I put tops up, then I put bottoms up, then I put gym stuff, then I put something else, but I don't know. I know what I'm like, and I'll probably end up just shoving it all up because it's easier. So I haven't decided on that part yet, but there's a lot, and there's a lot of designer bits as well. Like, I've literally cleared my wardrobe out of things that I have held on to for dear life because I love them, but I never use them or wear them. So there's a few designer bags that are going up. I won't be accepting stupid offers, just pre-warning, if you're gonna try and make a little low ball. I'm not gonna be accepting stupid offers. A lot of the bags that I'm selling have barely been used, like I'm talking once or twice. So I'm gonna be selling them for like the value that they would be worth, basically. So like if I look on Vestiaire, they'll be like kind of priced accordingly to what they should be. And yeah, there's a lot of stuff. But I thought I'd make a burrito first before I start deep diving into that, because I've got to go into that corner of my room that's like a Zoom corner, and I don't ever show it because it's embarrassing, but it's like basically the corner where everything's been shoved that needs like putting on Vinted or that doesn't have a home yet. And it's a corner, let me tell you. So I need to just get back into that in a minute and just try and weed some stuff out. And then I'm actually going to meet my friend Ebony for a coffee after as well, I think. I need to double check with her if we're still doing it, but we said at 2, which is in about an hour and a half, so we're gonna go to a cute little coffee shop around the corner, which does really good popcorn syrup. And my God, I had it before and it's so divine. So I think we're gonna go just do a little bit of work there, which will be really nice. But yeah, I need to get on with sorting some Vinted bits.